Welcome to the 2020 Rulang Primary School Mathematics Prelim Paper MCQ Answers. Grab your pens and papers and let's get started. Question 1. Find the value of 2 plus 5 times 8 minus 10 divided by 2. So I'm going to copy it out here, okay? 2 plus 5 times 8 minus 10 divided by 2. Okay, the first thing I'm going to do, order operations, is multiplication or division. So in this case, we have both. So let's choose the one on the left-hand side, okay? Because left-hand side to right-hand side. I'm going to underline what I'm going to do. So it's going to be 5 times 8 is 40. So we copy the rest that we didn't do. Okay, now that we are here, plus minus divide, we choose to do the divide first. Okay, so it's 2 plus 40 minus 10 divided by 2 is 5. Okay, now we have plus and minus. So we have to choose the one on the left-hand side first. So we're going to get 42 minus 5. Okay, 42 minus 5. We are going to get 37. So our answer is option number 3. Alright, so next, express 4 km 50 meters in km. So 1000 meter equals to 1 km. If we want to find 50 meter, we just take 1 over 1000 times 50. Okay, this method. Divide and then times. Okay, so take 1 divided by 1000 times 50. So you can cancel. Remember, this is over 1, so it's just 5 over 100, which is 0.05 km. Okay, this is a decimal, so hundredths, so 0.05. So don't forget that we have a 4 km here. So my answer would just be 4 plus 0.05, which is 4.05 km. Option number 2. Okay, for those of you who is wondering why it's 4.05, I'm going to do the working here. But for those who already know, you can just move on to question 3, okay? So this is how I get 4.05. So let's move on. 2 over 3 divided by 8 over 9. I am going to do it here. So when I see a divide, I need to change it to a times. And then what I do next is I flip it. Okay, instead of 8 over 9, it's 9 over 8. So now that we have this, we can do some cancellation. So 8 divided by 2 is 4. 3 divided by 3 is 1, 9 divided by 3 is 3. So my answer is 3 quarter, which is option number 1. And let's move on. 60% of a number is 30. What is the number? When I see what is the number, I'm looking for 100%. Okay, so I'm going to do the working here. 60% equals to 30. We're looking for 100%, right? So we can use this method again. This method comes in very, very handy for a lot of questions. Okay, so divide times. What divide by? What? So I have to choose this number, 30, divide by 60, and then I multiply by 100. Okay, so 30 and 60, I can cross because they're both zeros, and then 3 divided by 3 is 1, 6 divided by 3 is 2. Okay, so it's just 100 over 2. Which is, you have to remember that over means divide. Okay, so we are going to get 50. Answer is 2. Next one, a light bulb blinks 20 times in 10 seconds. How many times will it blink per minute? Minute is 60 seconds. Okay. 1 minute is 60 seconds, 1 hour is 60 minutes. So 10 seconds, I'm going to put S, it's 20 times. I need to find 60 seconds, right? I just need to use this method again. Okay, divide times. So 20 divided by 10 times 60. Okay, cross. I'm left with 2 times 60, which is 120. So my answer will be option 1. Okay, let's move on to the next question. Question 6. A rectangular tank 40 cm long, 30 cm wide, and 20 cm high contains water to a height of 8 cm. find the volume of water in the tank. So to find volume of water, instead of multiplying by the original height, which is 20 cm, we multiply by 8 instead, because that is the height of water. Okay? So to find volume, we just take length times breadth times height, which is 8. Okay? So 4 times 3 is 12, and then we have 2 zeros, so we just add it in, and then we multiply by 8. Okay, so this was the first thing I did, so I'm going to underline. So 1200 times 8, we have to do it the working. Okay, so we're going to get 9600 cm cube, which is option number 3. And next, in the figure, A, B, C, and E, F, G are isosceles triangles. So when we see isosceles triangles, we know that they have two equal angles at the base, okay? So we can see here that ABC is 64 degrees and EGF is 50 degrees. We have to find out what's FHC, which is here. So it's quite simple. If we apply the principles of isosceles triangles, okay? So from here, triangle ABC, we know that angle ACB equals to 64 degrees. Okay, so this is 64 degrees. And then from here, this isosceles triangle, we know that angle EFG equals to 50 degrees because it's at the base. So this is actually 50 degrees. Okay, so then to find out what's angle FHC, we just need to take 180 degrees minus 50 degrees and then minus 64 degrees. Okay, let's do this one first. 180 minus 50 is 130. So 130 minus 64 is 66 degrees. So my answer is option number 3. Let's move on. PQRS is a rhombus. Okay, so they have all same sides. And USR and VST are straight lines. When we see straight lines, we know that they have vertically opposite angles, okay? Since they crisscross each other. And UST is 134, PQR is 80 degrees. We need to find out VSP. So, it's a rhombus, right? So, what's my angle PSR? It will be equals to 80 degrees. Because the angle opposite is the same. So, this is 80 degrees, okay? And so what is angle VST? Angle VSR will be equals to angle UST, which is equals to 134 degrees. Why? Because they are vertically opposite. Okay? So this angle VSR is 134. To find out what is VSP, we just need to take 134 to minus 80 degrees. Okay? We are going to get 54 degrees, and that will be our answer, okay? Option 4. So let's just move on. Ming and Peter were standing next to each other and facing the same direction at first. Whatever direction they are facing, we do not know yet. So after Ming turned 135 degrees anti-clockwise, he was facing the northwest direction. In which direction should Peter turn in order to face the southwest direction? So before we go too in-depth, right, we need to draw the north, south, east, west directions, okay, so we can play around with it. So I'm going to draw it here, okay? So I'm going to use another color for Ming, probably red. Okay, so Ming turned 135 degrees anti-clockwise and he was facing the northwest direction. So north, south. West is, so Ming is here right now, because this is the northwest direction, correct? So he turned 135 degrees clockwise. We need to find out where he came from originally. So what we need to do is to move 135 degrees clockwise. Okay, since he moved anti-clockwise, we need to move the opposite way. So let's move 135 degrees anti-clockwise, okay? So we're going to start from here. So this is 90, and this is 135. So this is where they were originally, okay? So that means Peter is here right now. Okay, I'm going to use another color now. So, how, in which direction should Peter turn in order to face the southwest direction? Southwest is here. Okay, which direction should he turn? So, let's see. We have to turn this way, correct? So, follow the green arrow. We are moving anti-clockwise by how many degrees? So, this is 90, 180, and then this is 225. So, our answer will be option number 4. Okay. So, for those of you who are wondering, I'm going to elaborate a bit further regarding the angles. So, each angle here you are seeing, right, it's 45 degrees. Okay, so two of it will make you get 90 degrees. Okay, so that's how I get 225 degrees. Okay, so let's move on to the next one. Jeff's average score for both his English and mathematics was 78. So, average question, first thing I do is I draw this triangle. Okay, the average is 78 and two subjects. So, what's my total? I need to take 78 times 2. Okay, do the working here. So, I'm going to get 156. Okay, so which of the following could possibly be the marks he scored for his English and mathematics tests? So, we have no idea which one is correct unless we decide to add all of them, okay, one by one until we get the answer. Okay, it's tedious, but it's worth the mark, okay? So, 20 and 98, I'm going to do it here. Okay, this is not the answer. So, 30 and 48, I'm not going to do working, it's just 78. 39 and 39, it's, I don't think it's the answer, but let's do it. 78. Not the answer, so obviously our answer will be option 4. But I'm just going to do the working key to be extra careful. 156, we got it. Okay, so our answer is option number 4. And let's move on to the next one. In 11, a group of pupils were awarded points for their participation in the mathematics quiz as shown in the table below. So, 4 points, 10 pupils were awarded 4 points, 32 pupils were awarded 8 points, and so on. Okay, so pupils with better performance were awarded higher points, and tokens were given to the top 50 pupils. David did not receive a token. What was the highest total points? Highest points he could have got could have been awarded. So we have to count backwards, okay? So obviously if you have 20 points, you're the highest, you got the highest marks, and you will be given the tokens. So 19 you also will be given. So let's count. Those who get 20 points and 19 points, the total number is 23. So these 23 pupils, they will get their tokens. So how about those who got 17? Let's take 23 plus 27. We are gonna get 50. So these pupils in these three groups, they got their tokens because it adds up to 50. Okay, so David did not receive a token. What was the highest points he could have been awarded? So 20 is out, 17 is out. So the highest point between 10 and 15 will be 15. Okay, so that's how you do this question. Let's move on. Which of the following fractions will become the largest fraction when 1 is added to its numerator? So I'm going to add 1 to the numerator for everything, okay? So for this, I'm going to get 2/3. This I'm going to get 3/5. This I'm going to get 5/9. And this, I'm going to get 6/12. Okay? So, let us... So, this is just equals to half. Okay, if I simplify it, 6/12. So, 3, 5, and 9. I'm going to change it all to over 45. Okay? So, I'm going to do it here because there's more space. 2/3. To make it to over 45, I need to multiply by 15. Okay? So, 2 times 15 is 30. Okay? Next one, 3/5. To make it over 45, I need to times 9. Okay, so I'm going to get 27. And lastly, we have 5 over 9. To make it over 45, we need to times 5. Okay, so I'm going to get 25. So which one will be the largest? Out of this, these two are the smallest. Cancel, cancel. Okay, so 30 over 45. And this is half. This is bigger, okay? So the reason why I say this is bigger is because I can change this to over 30, okay? I can make it 20 over 30. And this one I can make it over 30 or so. I just have to times 15. Okay, I'm gonna get 15 out of 30. This one is times 10 to top. And 10 to bottom. So which one is bigger? 1 is still the biggest, okay? So my answer is 1. Let's move on. Rina spent 3 over 8 as much money as Alice. So you see all this ratio here? We have to use ratio also. So Rina is 2, Alice it's 3 is to 8. And let's move on. And half as much money as Clara. So when you have a sentence like that, the 1 you need actually still belongs to Rina. So it's R is to C is 1 is to 2. Okay? So find the ratio of the amount of money Rina spent to the total amount of money the three girls spent. To find the total the three girls spent, I need to make Rina the same. We have Rina 3 units here and Rina 1 unit here. So it's not going to work out. We're going to make both of them the same. So what I can do is I multiply by 3 for the one on my right hand side. I'm going to get 3 is to 6. Okay, I'm going to continue it here. So R is to A is to C will be equals to 3 is to 8 is to 6. Okay, and what's the total? The total is 3 plus 8 plus 6, which is equals to 17 units. Okay, so Rina is to total will be 3 is to 17. Okay, my answer is 4. So let's move on to question 14. The figure is formed by joining two semicircles of radius 5 cm. We have to find the perimeter of the figure and leave our answers in terms of pi. So when we find perimeter, first thing that comes to mind will be to find the diameter. So if my radius is 5, my diameter will be 5 plus 5, which is equals to 10 cm. So let us find out the circumference of a semicircle first. So we take half times pi times 10. Okay? So when you see questions like that and we have to leave it in terms of pi, we don't touch the pi. Okay, so we do half times 10 times pi. And we're going to get 10 over 2 pi, which is equals to 10 divided by 2, which is 5. Okay, so it's 5 pi cm. I'm going to use a red color to draw something. So this is 5 pi. And this is 5 pi. Okay? So don't forget that we still have this straight line and this straight line here. Okay? So I'm going to continue a few more steps. I'm going to draw a line here. So my diameter is 10. So, to find out this part, I just need to take 10 to minus 3, which is equals to 7 cm. So, this part is 7 cm. Which means that this part is also 7 cm. Okay? Because it's the same thing, my diameter are minus 3. Okay? So, the total, let's find out. 5 pi plus 5 pi plus 7 plus 7 equals to 10 pi plus 14. Okay, so my answer is option number 1. Okay, the answer should put the answer is number 2, but it's not correct. It should be number 1. Okay, so let's move on to the last question. Okay, question 15. A piece of paper A, B, C, D was in the shape of a trapezium before it was folded along the lines of EF, as shown in the figure below. AB is parallel to DE. Okay, so we have to find out what is CFE. First things first, I would like to draw the original trapezium without it being folded. Okay, so this way we can see and compare. I'm going to use a color that's not black, okay? So we can see it. Okay, so here you see my H here is originally my C. Okay, and another thing to know is that since it's folded, right, this angle and this angle is the same. Okay, so if we have this angle here and we have this angle here, we can find out what CFE, because this CFE is a triangle on its own. Okay, so let's find out what is CEF first. So angle CEF, it belongs on a straight line, correct? So I have to take 180 to minus 150, and then it's shared, okay, with another angle, and they're the same, so we can divide by 2. Okay, so this is 30 divided by 2. 30 divided by 2 is 15, okay? So this is 15. So what about this angle? This angle here. They're the same thing. Okay? This is just folded up. So to find out what is BCE, I just need to take 180 to minus 134. Okay? Because they're angle in between parallel lines. So I'm going to get 46 degrees. Okay? And yeah, because they said AB is parallel to DE. Okay, so they are in between parallel lines. So we have it. This is 46 degrees. So we can just do our question now. CFE is equals to 180 minus 46 minus 15 degrees. 180 minus 46 is just 134. So we need to do one last step. It is 119 degrees. Okay, our answer is option number 4. And that's it for this paper. Congrats on making it this far. And I'll see you in the next paper, which is the booklet B of this paper 1. Okay.